at Marty Wilson's Gallery, and my name's Jordan, and I work with Marty, and I always ask him what's the stories on his paintings and why he paints them. So today, we decided to have a little story time.
Yeah. Well, you were asking me about this painting called Heads Up. You know, all my paintings actually come from real life experiences. So I don't paint anything if I haven't lived it. And this painting is called Heads Up, and it was actually the inspiration that I used for my logo. But this painting in particular, we fished one of the very first Mississippi Big Game Fishing Club tournaments out of Venice. And I was down there with a real good friend of mine named Max Pace, and we was in some kind of little split windshield Seabird or something with a single outboard motor, and it had a makeshift T-top, and it had a little belly band on top, so we could get up there and get off the surface and actually see the blue water rip and stuff. And we're pulling baits down this rip, and it was pretty wide grass line, and we were it was kind of broken grass on that side, and it was trying to form on this side because those currents right there were the blue water rip and the blue green meet. Those two bodies of water slam together and they push against each other in the sargassum, which is a offshore grass that actually grows on the surface. It's the only structure for small fish to live because you're in 5,000 foot of water. So they're not living on the bottom, they're living on the surface. And that grass line could be miles and it could be a football field wide. So all your bait fish congregate there, and when there's bait fish, there's your food source, and the whole food chain's there because your bigger fish come in with your mahis and your tuna and your wahoo come in to eat the bait fish, and then here comes Mr. Blue and he's coming in like a boss and he's eating the baby mahis and the baby tuna and what he makes a living on. So we're pulling baits down this rip, and you know, I'm up in the belly band and it's still kind of broken on our side, on the tight side. So the baits are picking up grass on the hooks. So you gotta just constantly clean the baits. And you know, you just dump the spool, let the bait drop, slam it back in gear, crank it about 15 times, and try to clear the grass off the baits, because these guys don't get 15 foot or 10 foot being stupid, because they won't eat it if it's got grass on it. You're trying to fool that very smart and old fish into eating a piece of plastic. Right?
Yeah.
So it's kind of difficult. It's kind of a difficult game. So I'm cleaning the baits, right? And I had just got the bait clean. Blue smashes it. I had just caught a big mahi. So, we do a rotation in the boat. That's how you do it offshore. Somebody catches the fish, next man up. So here we are, and we got this blue on, dumping the spool right out of the freaking belly band. And I'm up there just... And I get the rod out of the rod holder, and it's just dumping the spool. And I'm like, oh, here he is. Here he is. This is the one. This is the man. And Max's brother, Mike, it was his turn up. And Mike's down in the cockpit going, "Dad, give him to me." And I'm like, "No, I can't yet. He's running too hard." Because I didn't want to give up the fish. Awesome. I knew it was the man. You know, you could tell when that fish eats. When a dolphin eats or something like that, they'll eat, they'll scream drag, and then they're jumping. But when a big blue eats, he dumps it, pins the rod to the rod holder, and then he'll come up and jump. But you can tell by the way that spool is emptying by what size fish is on there. So this is a freight train hooked to the other end of it, and it's just going south. Just as fast as you can, and you're watching the line just fucking disappear. It's crazy. So I'm sitting there, and Mike's going, hand me the rod. And I'm like, "No, I can't yet." I'm thinking, how can I keep this fish? So finally, I'm like, "Okay." He started slowing down, and he almost literally stopped. So I hand the rod to Mike. I'm like, "Real." And he starts cranking. The fish goes on the other side of the rip, comes up, and sticks his head out of the water, dead still, and just starts thrashing and does this big white water boil on the other side of the rib, and it's just his head. and I'm like, holy cow, it's a big fish.
And that was it.
Well, no, there's more, because he was doing that, and Mike's cranking on it. The line's up under the rift. The fish goes back down, sounds, and we don't have a fighting chair in this boat. So we're fighting the fish literally off an ice chest, right? So he's using an ice chest fighting chair. The fish sounds, probably goes down, I don't know, 1,000, 1,200 foot. Straight down. So we're knocked in freaking neutral. We're sitting there in neutral. He's fighting this fish up. We're in crystal clear, pristine blue water. Finally, I see the fish coming up because I'm in the freaking belly band and I'm standing up there and I'm watching him come up. And at about 150 foot, I'm seeing color of him. And here he comes and he's got this 500 pound sea turtle just right on his butt. And I'm watching the marlin and he's regurgitating what he ate probably the night before, because he's so under stress and pressure that they get under pressure, so he's steady regurgitating. The sea turtle's eating it as fast as he can, right? So they come up, they get up right behind the motors, and when they get up behind the motors, the marlin comes up, and the marlin takes a left and swims around the boat this way. The sea turtle comes up, and then he runs into the exhaust of the outboard motor. And he comes up to it, and he just falls in love with the freaking exhaust that's blowing into the water. And I don't know why, it was just weird. And here's this 500-pound sea turtle right behind the motors with a head the size of a football. And the marlin comes across here. Mike spins on the ice chest. He's fighting the fish. The marlin comes swing back around, comes right behind the motors, and then the line is zipping through the water, and it comes about 2 feet away from the sea turtle's shell. And now we're fishing a tournament for the Mississippi Big Game Fishing Club, and we're like, and I'm like, oh, if the line touches that sea turtle shell, it's gonna cut it, you know, and we're gonna lose this fish. So come out of the tower, I go back behind the motors, and I gingerly start pushing the turtle's head with my foot. You know, I'm trying to be gentle, because I love the sea turtles. I absolutely adore them. They're amazing creatures. And I finally got him away from the motors enough to get him disinterested in the exhaust. And then he just kind of moves off and goes down. The marlin comes back around the boat, does a half circle on the boat, and just as he got to the bow, he jumps. Boom! And the boat was there. Slammed into the side of the boat, came up on the bow rail, thrashing, ripped the bow rail off. I'm back up in the belly band. And I'm standing up there watching this go down, and there's this 350-pound blue laying on the bow of the boat, and he's just tearing it up. And I'm looking at it going, oh my God, I can't believe this is going on. I'm thinking, man, I should take a picture. I had a camera hanging off my wrist the whole time. Never thought to take a picture. And I went, oh, and I picked the camera up, and just as I went to take the picture, he went over the side, and I got a picture of a splash, right? And as soon as he hit the water, he greyhounded straight away from the boat, jumped about three times, and then laid over on his side and came back to the boat just with his bill coming straight towards his end of his day. He killed himself. So we got him to the side of the boat. His eyeball was gone. All his scales were going down this side. We grabbed him. We slipped him up into the side of the boat. We went back to Venice Marina, to South Pass. And it was a catch and release tournament. And we told him the story and why we had this dead marlin, because look, we've released hundreds of them. Releasing them is the way to go. They're not, they have no food value. It's a sport of games. This is what we want to go do, is catch them and then release them, you know, and revive them and release them so we can catch them again, you know. But so they took our story, saw the marlin, and we ended up winning first place out of a damn split window Sea Ray single outboard motor.
That's awesome.
In Venice, you know.
That's awesome.
It's crazy. But so that was called Heads Up, because it was just his head coming up on the other side of the rip, you know. And it's those experiences that I live, that I try to paint through my paintings and capture them forever. I'm a lucky man.
That's an amazing story, actually.
Yeah, thank you, man.
Well, about wrapped it up.
Hey guys, if you like that, we got more to come. Click here to subscribe. And if you like the art, go to MortyWilson.com. We got apparel and jewelry and more. So come check us out.